if I were starting my new channel today, I would certainly do certain things differently, because let's face the facts, nowadays on YouTube we can't grow anymore without at least applying a few strategies. Hey YouTubers, Nico here. Let's talk about three strategies today that help small YouTubers to grow their channels, particularly from zero subscribers and zero views. And if you are a well-established channel, well, make sure that you also apply these strategies. The last one that I will tell you is not something that everyone is already doing. So let's get started. Number one is certainly SEO, ranking your videos in search, because if you don't have any audience yet, well, then you can find your first audience through YouTube search. But I have to say, if you really start from zero, then it can be very tough to find search terms that have low enough competition, because you have to know if you learn the technique of applying SEO to optimize your metadata of your video, then there is one critical step. You have to focus your metadata on a search term that has low enough competition. And if you really start from zero, then sometimes there is just no way, or it's really, really difficult to find those search terms where even a new channel can rank. So you might have to postpone SEO to the point where you have collected 50 or 100 subscribers, and then it is a little bit easier to find search terms with low enough competition. But until you reach this point, already start doing SEO, because as soon as your channel grows to this certain size, then your older videos will be able to start to rank as well. But that said, if you want to learn the critical element of SEO, ranking for search terms that have low enough competition, well then check out this video where I explain the whole concept in more detail. But okay, if SEO doesn't really work from zero, what can you do in addition to that so you get to the first initial 50 or 100 subscribers? Well, there we come to strategy number two, which is sharing your videos on social media. You wonder probably, how can you do that? Because usually if you're starting out, you don't have a social media following on Twitter or Facebook or so on. So how do you get proper outreach on social media then? Well, you can use groups or forums on social media. So like Facebook groups or subreddits, everywhere where people with the interest in the type of videos that you produce roam around, discuss those topics where you could potentially share your videos. But be careful there. People in forums don't like to have videos link drop, basically. Yeah, you can't just share your videos there and then they will suddenly watch your videos. They want to keep their community clean. They don't like people who just share their video and then leave. What you need to do in order to share your videos in those existing communities, who of course are many people who give you a lot of outreach for your video, well, you have to become friends of those communities. You have to be a member who discusses with them, who is a valued member in this community. And once you become that, then you can also share your videos. Ideally, by the way, you would not just share any video, but since you're discussing with them already in that Facebook group, let's say, you already know what they are interested in, and then you might even make videos just for them. And they welcome that then, of course. So this is a way where you don't need any following on social media, but you can already gain a lot of outreach and with that bootstrap your channel. I once did a video where I explained this concept in much more details. So if you're interested, check out this video. And finally, strategy number three, which is actually a strategy that even established channels don't always apply, which is a way to multiplicate the views that you already get. The basic idea is that if you already have viewers on your videos, then you want to make more out of those people. Those people viewed a video of yours, and ideally, they even view another video afterwards. And that basically then multiplicates the views that you get. The more the people watch, ideally binge watching your content, the better for your channel. So one core technique is the view handoff method. That is actually coined by Brian G. Johnson and is really a simple but effective technique where you recommend one other video of yours at the end of your video. Basically, what you do, you have your video, you talk through your video, and at the end, you choose one related video that they should watch next because it makes sense in the context of your video. So what you do in the end of the video is to pitch to motivate your viewers to watch that video next. And if you really want to understand how this view handoff method works, well then check out this video where Brian G. Johnson, who coined this term, view handoff method, explains how to do it. This is really a powerful strategy, and I hope all those strategies helped. Cheers, my friends.